Kung Fu Academy. Thank you for coming out. We got about an hour demonstration, so be ready for some really cool stuff. You know, some people have seen some of our things before. We got some new stuff going on this year. We got a lot of new students. We're so proud of our school. It has grown. And we're happy to be obliged to show you exactly what we're doing at Tigon the Red Kung Fu Academy. My name is Sifu Jimbo Carino. I'm the chief instructor at Tigon the Red Kung Fu Academy. My students, my assistant instructors, you won't see them, but they're underneath that lion suit, but you're gonna make a lion come to life. We start out with this demonstration with a lion dance, okay? The lion dance signifies good luck. It also chases away the evil spirits. So we're gonna have a good demonstration. Make sure that everybody here has a good time. Are you ready to get started? Everybody ready to get started? Alright, let's see. Alright. Now we wanna make sure we have enough room around here because we do have weapon sets. We have some forms and choreographed movements where we use real weapons. So I want everybody to pay attention. Make sure there's not anybody walking through the stage. We got people walking around here. Make sure that everybody keeps their eyes open, okay? Thank you. Here we go. Let's get started. Jordan just went out But I'm gonna make him do something again, okay? So get your breath, Jordan. Jordan's gonna be performing what we call Kwan Yang Kwan, okay? Kwan Yang Kwan is a staff form. And a staff, in many instances, was used as a farm implement. It was also used as a weapon of defense, okay? This form, Kwan Yang Kwan, actually means tiger among sheep, okay? Tiger among sheep, or the shepherd's staff, okay? Jordan's gonna be performing Kwan Yang Kwan. You ready? And Rain Richmond performing a form we call Chao Cup Darn Do. Darn Do means saber. The infantry, the frontline guys, okay? It is a weapon that's got a a dull backside and a really sharp front end, okay? And it was used to, you might say this, but this is bringing back the history of a culture. It was used to actually hack through and cut through armor. So what we're experiencing today is what they call a martial art, art of war, okay? And this is part of a lot of cultures, and what we're trying to do is make sure that this history and this culture survives here in America, okay? So we're doing everything that we do in our efforts is to be able to perform these movements that they were passed down from hundreds and hundreds of years. But some of these forms you're fixing to see are actually close to 1,000 years old. So you're seeing something that's passed down from history, okay? And we try to be as authentic as possible. All right, number three. So today we're performing not as individuals but together as a school. So we're letting the orange belts perform what they just got through finishing to get their orange belt. Learjia Kwan. Learjia Kwan in Chinese means two-sectional staff. And if you notice, a two-sectional staff, a staff is a stick. It's all staff, but it's Kwan, stick. Okay? Learjia Kwan means two-sectional stick. Okay? Or nunchucks. Okay? In Okinawa, it's nunchucks. But they also do this in China, okay? All right, our next performance is my yellow belt tiny tiger, okay? My yellow belt tiny tigers, excuse me, huh? Tigers, come on, yellow belt tigers. All right, they're gonna be performing a form we call Kung Le Kung. You gotta step back just a little bit. Kung Le Kung means continuing fist. This is the long version. This is the version that actually takes about three times longer than most styles' original forms. This is one of the first forms that you learn. Kung Le Kung has developed strength and endurance for this long, okay? And a perseverance, so you have to stick with it. And we got Christian and Addie gonna perform Tiger Kung Le Kung. Oh,
gonna let them beat y'all. So throw those hands up high. I wanna change your body, move from side to side. That's right, cause we just begun. Party people in the place, yeah, we're having fun. Oh yeah, I'm gonna be a big star. I'm gonna lay it on and go, woo-ha! Cause when the move gets excited, when everybody's now gonna buy it.
Pretty long form, huh? They did good. Okay, now, my Tiny Tigers are going to perform the same form, but we shortened it up a little bit, okay? We shortened it up a little bit. Tiny Tigers are 7, 8, 9 years old. They have to sit there and wait to try to get their yellow belt and do 128 moves like you just saw. I might not ever see them again, okay? But we shorten it up a little bit so that they can, you know, they actually keep their efforts and all their diligence in line so they keep coming back to class. They know that they have just a few more moves and a few more moves and they get their yellow belt, okay? But I want you to see them today. They're going to be performing Tiny Tiger Kung La Kung. Y'all ready? All right, here we go.
They're going to do the old school.
These are my ones that just got started. You think, oh, they just got started. What can they really learn? They just got started. Okay. You're gonna see what they learn. That's gonna be exciting. You're gonna see what they're gonna learn. They learn what we call our first form. It's called say phone, say back. Say phone, say back means four corners defending, four corners attacking. It was actually used as a game in China. Okay. You actually can do these moves and counter move with a partner. Okay. And the first person that can mess up the other guy but still doing the same moves is the winner. Okay? But first we do this form without a partner. They're gonna do it by themselves. We're gonna do it as a group. So we're gonna start out with my tiny tigers. We're gonna be doing say phone, say bay. So hold on 1 second. Tigers, can you give me another hand? All right. Now see, the form they just did, say phone, say bay, they build a solid foundation. So when they do their techniques, they have to learn these different stances, a low stance, a horse stance. In order to develop power, you have to be able to use your lower body. Your lower body has to transition back and forth. So when they throw a punch, it's not just with your hand or just with your arm, it's with your lower body. They start that from the beginning, so they build a strong foundation. We don't just get them out there and throw gloves on and let them start, you know, kicking and punching each other. It doesn't happen. They're going to start, they're going to finish this form, they're going to understand what the techniques are, how to throw them, and why. And then we let them do a little sparring. That's the fun part, okay? Now, I got a real treat for you now. Here's some of my guys that have been with me in Seaview, Austin for over a year. Okay? They've already progressed to their green belt, which is the intermediate belt. That's just a testament to their dedication and how much effort they're putting forth into their training. And you can see that from the beginning to where they are now, it's an awesome, awesome experience to see this happen. They blossom and grow in their strength and their functioning, go to school, better students, and they go to school even in their athleticism and their classes. They can perform and outperform almost all their classmates. And why? I'm going to just say, I know why. They're doing Kung Fu. Alright? So here we go. We're going to get our green belts. We'll be performing Dai Chin Kung. Alright? Andre, come on right up. Thank you. pretty good for a bunch of youngsters, huh? That's a long form. That's a strength building form. See how long it is? All the spins, all the coordinating, all the low stance takes a lot of effort. And they put forth a lot of effort into learning that form, and that's why they're wearing their green belt. Well, I guess it's my turn. Don't make fun of me if I get out of breath, okay? I'm getting old. I'm performing a form called Shu Fa Do.
Everybody give it up to Sifu Jimbo. Give him a hand. He's an incredible instructor. All the time he is before and through teaching all that. Traditional martial arts. I've been with him since I was 4 years old. He's just one of my biggest mentors, role models, and unbelievable guys. He's going to be performing Shu Fa Do. It's a snowflake saber. Okay, a lot of big, pretty movements in it. Very dangerous. So everybody heads up, weapon on the floor.
Big weapon. All right, where's my book? Who's next?
All right,
I have another special guest who'll be performing next. If it wasn't for Michael Laban, we wouldn't even be able to have this school, okay? Michael is a great asset to our school. He's the one that provides us with a building where we can train. But he's also a very diligent student. He's been practicing martial arts for probably near as long as I have, 30 years. And I think he's older than me. And today, he's going to be performing a form called Tong Kyun. And this form dates back to the Tang Dynasty, okay, which was a cultural revolution in China, where a lot of things were happening and growing and being created in art and sciences. And this form comes from that dynasty. And this form is named after that dynasty. It's called Tong Kyun or Tong Fist. Okay? The meaning behind this form is conditioning. Okay? My teacher told me 20-something years ago that when I started, I was about same height as I am, about 168, 170 pounds, had a 30-inch waist, broad shoulder, and he told me, when you get done with this form, you will not look like an American anymore. You'll be built like a refrigerator. You'll have no more small waist, and you'll be built like a square. I said, what? I don't want that. But it develops necessary muscles, okay? It develops your waistline, develops strong, explosive waistline movements using your legs, using a lot of techniques that are implemented in this form. So you can tell by all of us, we feel like refrigerators. All right. See for Michael Levin, come on. Next on our list is going to be my assistant instructor at Taekwondo Red Kung Fu Academy, Sequel Joseph Wade. Okay? You know, Joseph is my guy in the crowd. Joe, you ever see the crowd? Get out of the crowd. Joseph, he works three jobs. One of them including teaching Kung Fu. School teaching, working at the CSI department, the Shreveport Police Department, substitute school teacher. He comes to the Kung Fu school and teaches. The service with his church. Sequel Joseph is probably one of the best persons I know on this planet, okay? And he is a definite tribute to our school. Sequel Joseph trained with one of my classmates many years ago as his instructor, Nate Minton. Nate passed away years ago, several years ago. But to my attribute and to Sequel Joseph's continuing in the martial arts, his teacher had told him one time, said, you know, if anything were to happen to him, go train with Sequel Jimbo. And he took it, passed away. And unbeknownst to me, Sequel Joseph told me that, and I was like, wow, blown away. So he's with us now, he's training with us, he teaches for us, and we can't be more proud to have him as my assistant instructor. Please give him a round of applause. Dude, you know what you want to do?
Hey guys, how y'all doing this morning? Good to be here. Okay guys, a lot of you guys see that they work with these weapons, the staff, concept, different sticks and stuff, different bladed weapons. You see the form that we do, you know, as an exercise. What I'm going to show you today is how to strike some of those weapons. I'm going to go slow, fast. When I get to the nut jumps, I want to get a little bit of crowd participation. Okay? Can I count on you guys?
Yeah.
All right.
Bob, he's speechless. I'm speechless too. You ready to see what Joe's? See what Joe's gonna show you how to strike each point with a step. Rattan is a vine that comes off a tree. It's very flexible. It's a short step. Do the same thing with the short stab as you do with the long stab. Now see if Joe's been doing a lunge-up quan or two-sectional stab or nunchuck.
Back.
volunteer. Let's go.
Don't be shy.
Come on, Steve. Come on. What we got? Come on. What we got? Come on, girl. Got one more, hey, Steve and Joe. Oh, all right, Miss Sabrina, come on, Miss Sabrina. All right. Sabrina, all right. Watch yourself. There you go. Oh, watch yourself. There you go. Oh. Get that chicken wing. Does everybody understand now why when you see the kids do this stuff, how easy they make it look? Not easy. That's it, Bear. Look at that. All right, Bear. Right here.
One, two.
Oh, I can't do that.
Do two twists, Bear.
Two.
All right, Bear. Go on, Steve. All right, Steven.
Well, that's the road.
You can do it. You can do it. Well, she did even harder. Oh, look at that. That's awesome. All right. Two twists, baby. You can do it.
One,
two. Go, baby. Get up. Keep it going. And then flip it again.
Oh.
Flip it back. Straight back. Got some music, Steve? Alright, they get to do their own form, I hear you. Oh, here we go! Keep it going, all right.
you. Alright, listen up. We got a little change of plans. We're actually going to do our finale first. Okay? One of our instructors has to leave. He's got a special engagement. So we're going to do our finale first. So you can check this out. This, I need you to pay attention. Do not try this at home. These are real nails, okay? I know you've been to sideboard, you know, you can sit on one and then, you know, go up underneath you and you won't poke you or anything like that. These will poke you. Do not do this at home, okay? Only students of mine that have been training for many years to develop their internal energy, which they call chi, are allowed to do this, okay? You're a child, you are not allowed to do this. Okay? You're learning to do this. When you learn to do this, they have to develop that internal strength through a period of training where they develop their body to where you can withstand pain. Okay? Pain is a part of martial arts. If you can deal with that, then you can handle yourself. If you're in a fighting situation, you have more than five people beating up on you, you might stand a chance if you can handle the pain. Okay? And this is the same right here. Okay? So please, I need everybody to keep it down, allow them to really focus, and watch. It's an awesome little testament to their abilities. Here we go. We're performing the first part of a form called Fu Hawk to build their internal strength.
Yeah!
know, it's crazy, huh? Everybody turn around, show me your back. But no blood. No blood. You okay, Jordan? That was Jordan's first time. Give him a hand. All right, good double burden now. That's a lot of weight. That's a lot of weight. It really takes a lot of training to do that, okay? All right, Mike Galilee. Okay, we got a couple more feats of kung fu technique that we're going to show you. I want to bring my, I tell you what, Tiny Tigers, come on, line on up. We're going to do a sample class. Everybody give Michael a hand, Galilee, give Michael a hand, all right. Okay, so my Tiny Tigers are going to show you what it's like to train, okay? They're going to get out and show you an exhibition of what we do in a sample class, okay? Don't worry, you guys just stay where you're at. Attention. Good job. All right. All right, here we go. We always start off with two numbers in Chinese, yup and yi, okay? And that's how we spread out. You guys ready? Attention. Come on, baby. Arms is the part, please. You gotta spread out so you got some space. Good job. There we go. Arms is the part, please. I'll tell you, Chuck. Face up front and back. Good job. Left side in front. Boom. We start out showing a high heel kick. High heel kick. Are y'all ready, eBay? High heel kick, ready?
Go!
Go!
Yee! Go!
Go!
Back, busy bag. Show some speed.
No!
No! Back fish, ready?
No!
One of the hardest stances that we do. This develops the strength not only in their legs, but this develops the strength in their mind because this hurts. Okay? They're gonna do what we call a horse stance. And a horse stance is a stance that looks like you're riding a horse. Down low like this. Develops the strength in your legs. Well, after about 10 seconds, your legs feel like they're on fire. So you want to stand up. Okay? But if you stand up, that means your body is controlling your mind. If you can use your mind to control your body, I know it might hurt, but if you stay down longer and longer, you develop that strength, okay? And not only physical strength, but mental strength. If you develop that mental strength, then develop that spiritual strength, that heart, that indomitable spirit, not to give up. Are y'all ready? Kung Fu Jumping Jacks, and we start at an early age. Here you go, feet together. Kung Fu Jumping Jacks, eBay.
Yeah.
Hold it, don't move. 30 seconds. Hold it, be tough. Hold it, don't move. You gotta don't move, you gotta look straight ahead. Be solid as a mountain. A mountain doesn't move. Your face has gotta be concentrated. Your fingers spread apart like spider webs. Okay? Good job, get low, get low, get low. 5 seconds, 4, 3, two, one, attention. For the sake of time, I would have you, a few of you, come on out here and try that. Yeah. All right. Good job. Attention. Face the front and back. Bring the mats out. Bring the mats out. Go ahead and bring the mats out. Okay, we got a little treat for you. We're going to have the mats out here. All right. If you bring your kids to the Kung Fu school, we want them to be able to learn to defend themselves, okay? We don't teach them to be bullies, okay? That is not accepted. Nobody here is allowed to be a bully, but you should never be taken advantage of. So we teach our children to be able to endure a lot of things, but you have to defend yourself, and you have to. It comes down to your friends, your parents, your brothers and sisters. You need to defend them, and that's what we believe, and that's what we train to do, okay? And in order to do that, we teach these guys to do what we call free sparring. In free sparring, they wear hand pads, feet pads, mouthpiece, headgear, so they're all padded up. It's like I say, armor up, and they're all armored up, okay? Now, we don't allow any face contact, but my students learn what it's like for someone to, you know, throw a punch at them, throw a kick at them, something like that. You know how to get out of the way, how to take care of business, and move on, okay? But like I said, we don't teach them to do this so they can go out and perform this on their friends, or go out there and perform it on their dog or cat. No, don't go home and kick the dog or cat. That's not what we're trying to do, okay? So we're going to get out. We're going to get Aiden Carino out. I'm going to get Andre. Come on out, Andre. Andre Walker's going to be out here too. These are my two green belts. And they're going to perform. They're my tiny tigers. And they're going to start with a 3-minute match. No, 3 minutes. 3-point match. 3 minutes is a long time. All right, ready? Okay, I need center referee Austin Wynn. What's Austin? Austin working the crowd. All right, there we go. Come on, Austin. Okay, I need you guys to step one here. Aiden? Andre over there? Rain, I need you to judge. Okay, Rain right here. Alright. Need you guys over here? Make sure that you not go off the mats and fall on the brick. We don't need that, okay? You gotta be careful. Alright. Pay attention, Sifu Austin. Okay, hold on 1 second. This is a point area, the top of the head, side of the head, chest, tummy, okay? We want all kicks above the waist, to the side, the rib cage also point. No face contact, okay? They can kick and they can punch. No wild swings allowed. Alright, here we go. And you guys cheer for who you want to cheer for. Here we go. 3-point.
Alright.
Alright. Let's go, see something.
Let's go.
One for Andre, 1-0. Come on, Aiden, I get it back. Great. It'll be fast. Be smart, you guys. You see some good techniques. Good point.
Don't worry about it, bro.
Hey!
Let's go!
Keep it going, keep it going. Get away. See some reverse punches, guys. One, two.
Put your hand up.
Let's go.
Okay, 2-2. Two. Next one. There's a tie. All right. Good fight, you guys. All right, Andre and Aiden. All right, here we go. Okay, I need my green belts out. Let's take the mats off. I need my green belts out.
Go! my bench.
Thank you.
y'all see these guys amazing. Like, amazing. They have to pop one brick and the way the other one breaks over. This is one space, but the cancer is only quarter of an inch. Yeah, quarter of an inch space, you can have a good drive, good to break all the work.
Out of the way. All right, I'm Sifu Jimbo Carideo. I want to thank everybody for coming out. We had a wonderful time. Thank you for being patient and watching us. We enjoyed performing for you today. We're located at 1802 North Market in Shreveport. Look us up on our website, Tiger on the Red Kung Fu Academy. I need my tiny tigers up here first. Tiny tigers. Tiny Tigers in one line, please. I need my Tigers behind them. All right, my Tigers behind them. Let's go, let's go. I need my adults behind them. I need all everybody that helped, everybody that was involved in this demonstration today. I want you to be out here and line up. Everyone, we're Tiger on the Red Kung Fu Academy. I just want you to, as students and as instructors, we really want to tell the parents thank you. So I need all my students to say thank you very much. Right on, okay. So without our parents, without our grandparents, without our friends, without everybody that supports our school, it would not be possible. We want to thank you for coming out today. We got a wonderful year ahead of us. All these guys are going to be competing in these tournaments coming up. So if you ever hear about a tournament coming up and want to come support our school, our rank test, be happy to have you. Sifu Austin, you got anything you want to say? All right. Congratulations. I would like to thank as your Sifu, as your instructor, as a friend of your parents, I just want to tell my students I'm so proud of you guys. You guys did a wonderful job. We appreciate, and I appreciate everything you do. Every year we come out here and perform, and I tell you what, I can't be more proud. So I'll give you guys a hand. Are you all ready? Let's bow out. Let's call it a day. Attention!